Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate. Enhanced Edition. Blind. You need some ale. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. This might be a shorter episode because...
You bunch of chumps! What the hell do you think you was doing?
It might be shorter because I only have two things to do, and that is to... Well, we're gonna cure what's his name of his lycanthropy, or try anyway. What's her name? Adas? I don't remember her name. A Wells. The husband of the mage A Well. Okay, then we've got that. And we're going to take on Kahrk again, do a rematch, and that's it. Depending on the results of a poll I put up, which I have not yet currently put up, but it'll be before this video, the following episode is either going to be me going through the Black Pits edition, which is a enhanced... something added to the enhanced edition, or I'm going to be continuing the main quest, either one, so... I mean, true, I could start it this video, whichever the results are, but this gives a couple more days for people to get their votes in, and or for me to, you know, get my videos recorded. And number two, it starts off things in a nice, you know, roundabout way. Here begins the Black Pits, here begins the, you know, continuing the main quest, which is going to be helping one of the dukes. He is becoming ill by, looks like his own cleric, or priest. So, realistically speaking, he would be way dead, because we decided to do the Thurlag's Tower before that, and... track down the Serpents of Abathur, which is a mod for the game, and then we went to the Isle of Baldoran and just let him get sicker and sicker all the time. But yeah, I think we'll be fine in this case, and that's a little unrealistic. So I memorized one identify spell. We're gonna identify the chainmail that we picked up, and that's it. And then we're gonna go try to help what's his name get cured of his lycanthropy.
Alright.
Alright, we're gonna rest. And we raised what's her name? Off screen. Why can't I remember your name all of a sudden? Imuin. Like, I should know that in my sleep. Anyway, so what do we have here? Chainmail plus 3. This perfectly crafted chainmail is the standard armor of deep dwarf elite fighters. It is comprised of a mithril alloy and offers protection from all but the most determined attackers. Isn't mithril IL at the end? So armor class 2, 0 versus slashing, 4 versus crushing. But none of us even wear chainmail. Armor class 2, 0 slashing. This is 2, negative 1 versus slashing. And then these are even better. Armor class 0. Armor class 1, minus 2 versus slashing. So we're gonna sell that. Oh well. Now I think we found that on Kasia's gun, I believe. So let's see what this guy will buy from us before we move on.
All right.
Oh, we need to return all their things to her. I wanted to do that off screen. I mean, I could still. I forgot to do that. Wand of Frost. Here, take the chainmail plus 3. Gems. I found this on a random encounter here, just some hobgoblins. Those 3. You need some ale. So stand by. I will return all of Imowyn's things to her. Be right back. Okay, I took the liberty of storing quite a few things in here.
If Tempus wills it.
Hopefully it'll still be here if we ever need them. Some of this stuff has to do with the Serpents of Abathur mod, which are done with. Lugash's diary. This does not. Boldoran's logbook. This does, a dwarven artifact, and the warehouse key. The holy cloak is... apparently we can't even sell it. It's symbolic. Not enchanted. This is a diary having to do with the Serpents of Abathur. And this doll that we gave to Farthing, and then she turned into a werewolf later on. We had to kill her. That was sad. Sea charge, which I don't think we're going to need anymore, and the recipes and stuff of Dradeel. Empty bottle. This has to do with an extra mod quest. And this is Lathander's potion back from Baldur's Gate that's not actually a real potion.
All right.
And we get the guy some ale already. Alright, so we're going to return to... Thalantyr.
Sure.
And see if we can cure the guy of his lycanthropy, which is a quest we've had since almost the very beginning when we arrived at Thalantyr's in High Hedge. Shouldn't be that long to High Hedge. Yeah, right here. Still 20 hours.
Sure.
So we arrived and it's dark out, and it's still dark out. Oh, that's where the werewolf actually is, I believe. Unless we pick some up. Unless we forgot to pick some up, I mean. We've been going through arrows for Imowyn. So just in case we find her running low. Give us some more of these arrows of fire here. Okay. So you can load that one up. Yeah. Should we talk to Awel first or Thalantyr? Let's talk to Awel. Awel?
Speak.
I've heard you talking inside. What will you do? I'll see if I can help your husband. I will pray to the gods for your success, then. Yeah. Whatever you think might help. Because Thalantyr is not always successful, right? He wasn't successful in curing Melacamp, right? What was that arm mix-up? I forget.
Right. If Tempus wills it.
You don't need to be going over there where the golems are.
such menial tasks.
I sincerely hope you have some reason for bothering me. I've already stated that I wish you to leave. I brought you Belladonna. Now look at that. I did not think you could really find me some Belladonna. Well, I'll see what I can do with it. And that is that. Would you excuse me now? I have things to do. Potion against Lycanthropy. Anti-Chickenator. Thalantyr the Conjurer. Anti-Chickenator. Why does it say that? This potion contains mainly Belladonna flowers. Not really going to be helpful. What was that there? That looks special. The Maul of the Mighty, Tholin's Ogre Smasher, has weathered the storm of countless wars and battles. Originally the property of an elk tribe chieftain, the maul was forged to slay the increasing number of ogres and orcs along the Deserin River. Oh, I don't need that. I wonder, though, if there's anything I need to know. Let's see it in green, right? I think I have all the spells I need. I don't think there's anything I need to sell either. The butter knife of Baldur, we could sell for 500. Oh no, I'm keeping that around just in case we run across a chef who really needs a butter knife. I could have stored that as well, but oh no, forgot about that. We could also sell the Belladonna flowers for one each.
Why me?
Not worth much. So we just gave this to Awell.
Why me?
She is here, okay. There you are. Were you able to help my husband? I do not think that's to my taste. Please help us. I decided for the healing potion out of Belladonna. Oh, as opposed to, like, taking some of her blood or something. Now all that is left to do is give it to the werewolf somehow. How do I do that?
All right.
Give it to him. Oh, that's hers. Maybe have the stronger guy give it to the werewolf. Everything in order here. He's in here, is he not? The red eyes of the werewolf sparkle in the gloom of the hut. Apparently he has sensed you and is preparing to rip you apart. Take this! Throwing the antidote. The werewolf snatches at the flask flying toward him. For a moment, confusion is written on the face of the werewolf, and then he takes it. His humanity took over for a second. Ah! By the gods, what a nightmare. Who are you? Where am I? Yeah, so I was right. His name is Tonder. You are safe. We have set you free from lycanthropy. From the werewolf disease? What are you talking about? Awell, I must reach her. What?
Sure.
What's going on?
All right.
Well, first,
as well as I can.
Look, are there any goodies in here? No.
As directed.
Oh, you know, we have to go loot that chest and... What's his name's? Well, there is a back room.
Hey, how are things going? Good job.
That's your job. An aquamarine gem. Okay.
Hey, how are things going?
No less than done.
Thank you. So...
Why me?
You must return to her. Don't tell me she's a werewolf as well. Does the quest log say anything? Done quests. Awell says, there you are. I am very much indebted to you, lady. My husband is saved, and I never could have done it without your help. Tonder says, the last days are like a nightmare in my head. Awell has already told me what happened. We should relax a few days, sweetheart. Let's go to Baldur's Gate. A good idea. I think I would become crazy in that house. But I want to give a present to you, ma'am. Go into our house and open the chest there. Hidden under it is a secret compartment where you will find a good weapon. May it be of help to you. Okay, I guess besides the aquamarine where he took. Awell and Tonder were overjoyed that the man was freed from his curse. Alright. Back to the house to look for a special weapon. Don't tell me it's something else against lycanthropy.
Why me?
All right.
Oh, now there's another thing in here. Sword of Flame plus one. The blade burns with a magical fire, and a charring blast is released whenever a hit is scored. Meta Infernum is etched on the hilt, though it appears somewhat faded and may not be original to the sword. Alright. Plus one to Thaco, 1d8, plus one, and then plus one fire damage on top of that. Flashing, of course. Not usable by Cleric, Druid, Mage, Shaman, Beastmaster stuff. Okay, well... Is that at all preferable to... 1d8 plus 1. It's not as good as the Harrower. 1d8 plus 1. Plus 3 versus undead. Although it is slightly better with the damage. Because it has plus 1 fire damage on top of, you know, if we're not undead, it's a tiny bit better. This just slays the Burning Earth. 1d8 plus 1, and then plus 1 fire, plus 2 regenerating cold using undead. What about what he has? He has 1d8 plus 2. So sadly, we don't have a use for that. I suppose we'll be selling it. I wonder if Thalantyr would take that. I mean,
all right.
It's more like something you'd sell in a smithy, but that it is magical, maybe he would take it. He would buy it. Kind of close his doors, figure we'd never travel here again, but I was wrong. So he had it, yeah.
Butt kicking for goodness!
I don't know, you should yell that in his face. Probably wouldn't appreciate that. It's pretty grouchy. He will buy it for $23.75. Pleasure doing business with you.
I don't want... Alright. Alright.
Alright, now we have to go... deal with what's his name? Enemy. Oh. Skeletal.
Name it.
We got special against undead.
Go for the ice pool!
Oh, you know what we need? Does he sell magical bullets?
Give us victory! For right, I always am.
I don't think he does. We're kind of running out of those.
Hey, how are things going?
Why do I live in such a pissant town?
Love when he says that. Bullets plus one. Bullet of electricity plus one. 1d4 plus 1, 1d6 electrical damage. Save versus spell for none, so then I guess then you just still get that. 1d4 plus 1. Bullet of ice, bullet of fire, plus 1. I don't think electricity is often resisted, like... I'm not sure. Begin by 5. We need a lot of them. Stack them in 80. Bolts of ice. Keep things interesting. One, two, three, four. Are we close enough? Thank you. Okay. All right, even it out a little bit.
Sure.
Right.
Why me? Why me?
Ow. Hold the door. Come on, guys. Close the door. Thank you. Now we have to leave. Hopefully the bear doesn't mess with us. Okay, we have to return and get this lady's jar or something like that. So, I'll see you guys there. Okay, I'm not completely sure where this person is. I think somewhere over here. You can tell we haven't explored this area. I mean, we did, but then died. Horribly. So, since these last 2 hours, I'll just have them both take a potion of Fire Giant Strength now. And then any other buffs will be coming when stuff starts happening.
All right.
All right, where is this person? More this way? I don't remember her being all the way up on the edge of the map like that. Don't want it to run out. Okay, Karsa. He's driving me mad. Oh, please make it stop. Make him stop his screaming. Ah! Shut it up! What's wrong? What is driving you to madness? Lady, if you want help, you're going to have to calm down. It's in my head. It won't be quiet. Just keeps on whispering and whispering. You see this jar? Do you see it? We see the jar, lady. Now calm down and tell us what's happening. My companions and I, we entered the Firewine ruins and we found this jar. It drove them all mad. They hacked and they cut and the blood. So much blood. They're all dead now, and only I'm left. The voice. It tells me to say the name. If I say the name, it promises great rewards, but I won't. I won't. What do you want us to do, lady? How can we help you? Poor Karsa cannot be helped. You can't help Karsa. You must run, and run fast. Soon Karsa will not be able to resist. Soon Karsa will say its name. Then it will come. And they will be blood. My blood. Your blood. Yeah, maybe some of it. Just give us the jar, Karsa. We'll know what to do with it. Don't worry. No! Karsa will not give the jar. The jar is Karsa's and hers alone. Get away! Get away or Karsa will say the name, and we will all die. Give us the jar, Karsa. Give it to us now. You not take the jar from Karsa. It's mine. Mine. Stay away, or I say the name. Stay away. We're taking the jar from you, whether you like it or not. No! Kahrk! Almighty Kahrk! Emmerwin says, whoa, that's some really creepy magic there. Almighty Kahrk! You gotta love that laugh. Alright, our doom cometh.
Is that called?
What should we do? He's not attacking yet. Protection from evil? Which one is that? Well, she's dead.
Madness.
potentis.
That's her? Well, you better get closer to her. I am free, at last. Mortals, before you die, know that you have pleased Kahrk, mightiest of the ogre magi. Your death shall feed my power, for now I am weak. Now he's weak, can you imagine? You gonna cast that spell? Okay, so...
Good job.
Attack him. You attack him.
Yes,
you
a simple matter.
Get away. You get away.
No less than done.
So what I want to do...
I'm still
getting away, right?
I need an ale.
I hope we get this effects of this. Alright, so... Okay, so he's put up... Well, he casted Mirror Image. Okay. I'm gonna cast haste on these two. Looks like it got all except for me, but I'm standing right there. I'm gonna do dispel magic on him. Okay, it dispelled on us. That's not good. Then he took away the haste, didn't it? I'm not sure if this is going to be effective. But, what am I looking for? Not familiar with most of the icons here. She has dispel magic. What? Okay, I have greater Malazan. I'm gonna try that. He has mirror image on. I don't know if I will be casting greater Malazan on one of the mirrors images. And that looks like that, like some kind of evil flower. Try that.
They wish my ear.
And we'll do that stuff. Oh, you know what I want to do, though? Does he have this on? I have to click this. I don't know where I do that, though. Was he supposed to put it in his hand or something? I guess so. No? I'm not sure. I thought I had to click it. Wait, use item this. Okay. Okay, I guess he took that. Is that the mind shield?
You point, I punch.
Guessing so, mind shield. Yeah. Forty electricity damage. Wow. So I wanted to have him take that mind blocking spell. Oh wait. Well, you know what? Try to spell magic again.
Squeaky wheels get a kick.
Okay, move him aside. Oh, he's almost dead, this guy? Oh, wow. Watch him rise again or something. Oh, that wasn't bad at all. Huh. Greatest of the ogre magi. He wasn't nothing compared to Ick Latak or whatever the hell his name was. 85 gold, 73 gold. He's got a Zios gem, a black opal, a gold necklace, a regular katana.
Such menial tasks.
And she had a dagger. Well, that wasn't bad at all. Probably lucky with some stuff. I wonder if he actually dispelled some of it, like something from him. Kahrk, spell failed, casting. Kagan interrupted him. Kahrk, spell ineffective. Love it. And Kagan with the killing blow. I didn't even get a chance to take these potions.
You are a strong warrior. I respect that.
We're gonna take that. Magic blocking. I heard them each have one. Okay. So we found... some kind of magical meat. I got a knave's robe. And a protection scroll. Identify spell. Yeah. Protection from fire. Which we have quite a few of, I believe, by now. Yeah, four of them. And a knave's robe. I'm like 800 pounds, it's because I took that thing. So, just go like this. Where is it? just in case anything happens. I like to cast that spell outside of combat more because it just takes so long to cast. 58. And then finally, alright, let's finish the map.
Sure.
Kahrk defeated. Much easier than before. Also went up quite a few levels. Alright, we're going that way, so let's actually go this way first. Skeleton.
Name it.
Skeletons.
Go for the eyes, Boo! Go for the eyes!
My blade will cut you down to size!
Go for the eyes, Boo! Go for the eyes! Rask!
Clearing out the fog of war. A war dog. Plural.
Go for the eyes, Boo! Go for the eyes! Rask!
Tempest, give us victory!
Die, war dogs! Running, morale. Supposed to be a war dog, not a running from battle dog. There's a little bit of shadow here, a little fog of war here. Can I clear that? Yes. More skeletons.
All right.
So I thought this was going to be a short episode. Not really. It's almost over, though.
Yes?
Oh, yeah. Who is this again? Melium? I don't think we fought him last time, either. Could be wrong.
Go for the eyes, Boo! Go for the eyes! Rask!
Ah, don't go all the way around. Use ranged.
As well as I can.
We were just over there, weren't we? Okay, they're not attacking. Guys, let's attack our enemies. What the hell? Alright, something's going on.
Such menial tasks.
No one can move. Attack that. You attack that too. The others can just stand there if they want, I guess.
Hey, how are things going?
You wanna help out? You can help out.
Tempa, give us victory!
Well, now you'll move. I don't know, what was it with that? Okay.
Why me?
We have that little bit. Let's go get that little bit left. We'll be done. Yay. I will be leaving this place. Explored it all. This bothers me, but I'm not going to go all the way down. It doesn't bother me that much. So next episode, guys, depending on what you guys voted for, we will be... Yeah, next episode, Black Pits. DLC or additional content, whatever you'd want to call it. Wow. She got hurt.
What is your command?
Yeah, either Black Pits next episode or continuing with the main quest and helping out the Duke who is ill. Either one, we will see what that is next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.